powered by the Montana Television Network. This is the 5:30 News on Q2, Montana's news leader.
Good evening and thanks for joining us. I'm Russ Riesinger. We'll join Janelle a little bit later for a first look inside the St. Jude Dream Home. But first, an explosion at a refinery in Montana has sent emergency crews scrambling. That Great Falls refinery billowing smoke around 1 o'clock today, putting schools on high alert and shutting down streets in that area. MTN's Joe Husina has been on the scene all afternoon watching the situation unfold and has more on what's happened.
At the time of the initial explosion, I was actually several miles north of town, and I could immediately see a large plume of black smoke over the city. When I got to the scene, I went down to the Montana Club, just across the street from the refinery there. When I got on scene, I was actually close enough that some of the water being poured on the refinery was coming down and hitting me. Now, at that time, police already had the intersection closed off and began evacuating patrons from the Montana Club restaurant. When those people came out, one woman told me that they felt the building shake and heard the blast, then saw a large plume of fire coming from the refinery. Now, all the way up here, we're standing now. Employees at HCL Equipment said they also felt the blast and it forced one of their doors shut. Now, they also said that they had ash falling all the way up here and settling this far away. Now, they had the roads closed off for a pretty good while this afternoon, and all traffic in the area was shut down. But luckily, all employees were accounted for and things were allowed to reopen. In Great Falls, Joe Husinga, MTN News.
The refinery also releasing a statement tonight saying it's grateful that no one was injured, but it will be investigating to ensure that its employees' safety remains a top priority. And a shocking morning on the campus of Montana State University after the roof of one of the fitness centers collapsed there. Now, fortunately, no one was injured, but there is a lot of damage. MTN's Cody Boyer has been on the scene all day as investigators try to figure out what happened.
It's a tremendous shock. I mean, no one expected to wake up to a roof missing from a gymnasium this morning.
It started with a call at around 2:20 Thursday morning. MSU spokesperson Michael Becker says crews from Bozeman Fire Department and MSU Campus Police responded, only to find a gaping hole where the South Gym's roof used to be.
Overnight, we had emergency responders on scene, making sure that everything was safe as could possibly be. That means turning off utilities, it means taking care of electrical, and assessing the situation.
Now, Michael says it was the entire roof that did cave in, and it caused a lot of damage to the floor as well inside that South Gym. While they are going to take a while to figure out what exactly caused this, students say this place was incredibly important to them.
We usually go to the gym every morning, and he said, hey, like, we're not going to be able to go to the gym today. Do you want the good news or the bad news?
Stephanie Stanger says she and her husband relied on the complex every day as a study hall and a place just to get warm.
Oh, so important. This is like 100% of my day. I'll go, I study there. It's like I get everything done at the gym. Plus they have the fire. It's the only place on campus that has the fire.
We're assessing the structural integrity of the rest of the walls of the building, of that gymnasium, and that's an assessment that's ongoing.
Becker says that is why all buildings connected to the South Gym will be closed until further notice. Importantly, the building was closed at the time and no one was hurt.
MSU is immensely grateful that we had no injuries from this event.
It's a real bummer. I hope they get it up and running and we can get back in it soon.
Becker did tell us that the university would be notifying faculty and students over social media as to the progress of the cleanup and the investigation. Crews will also be checking the surrounding buildings like Schroyer Gym and the Field House to make sure they were not impacted by this. In Bozeman, Cody Boyer, MTN News.
And while we still don't know what caused the roof of that building to collapse, but with the heavy snowpack this winter, home and business owners are advised to know the warning signs of potential damage. In fact, the state requires all buildings to meet certain standards when constructed to prevent structural damage from snowpack. According to FEMA, 1 foot of snow depth can range from 3 to 21 pounds per square foot, depending on the moisture content. Montana code requires a minimum snow load of 30 pounds per square foot for new buildings. Structural engineer Aubrey Yerger says a roof collapse is relatively uncommon, but people should be concerned if they see sagging on the roof, new cracking in the interior, water leaks, or ice dams.
especially as we're starting to get into those warmer temperatures. Ice dams that have accumulated near the edge of your roof, that would prevent snow from sliding off.
Jurger says if people are concerned about the amount of snow on their roof, they can or should contact a contractor to remove it to make sure no inadvertent damage is caused. A Sweetgrass County deputy is being honored for saving a man who was found parked unconscious on the interstate suffering from hypothermia. Deputy Cody Kreiner was given an award for his quick action back on February 6th. That day, the temperatures were 10 below zero. Kreiner was checking what he thought was an abandoned car at a rest stop near Big Timber. The car was completely frozen over, and inside was a 33-year-old unresponsive man from Washington who'd been in the car for about 5 hours. Deputy Kreiner busted out a window, started care until an ambulance arrived. Kreiner says he regularly keeps emergency blankets in his vehicle, so he covered the unconscious driver and even placed the beanie from his own head onto the victim, who was then taken to a hospital for care. Well, state lawmakers on the House Appropriations Committee returned to Helena today after their mid-session break, and they immediately began their multi-day hearing on the major spending bill for the state government. Governor Steve Bullock's budget director led off the hearing, saying the bill falls short on key areas of services provided by state government. House Bill 2 is the foundation of the state's $10.4 billion budget for the next 2 years. State Budget Director Tom Livers said the Bullock administration is worried that the bill cuts too many positions, many of which had been left open during last year's budget crisis. He says if those positions are cut, then a substandard level of service will become permanent in many areas.
There are a couple ways to make the cuts. I think the legislature can explicitly decide what services will no longer be offered, or we can decide by default to keep doing everything we're doing, but the level at which we're going to be doing it, it's going to be at standards that none of us are proud of, or none of us really even thinks is adequate.
The panel will hold 2 or 3 days of hearings on the bill this week and then start voting on it by Monday. Well, Billings making the top 25, coming in at 24 on the top 100 best places to live in America. A livability.com article mentions MSUB, the Billings Symphony, the Moss Mansion, and Halloween on Clark Avenue as some of Magic City's uniqueness. Helena at number 27 and Great Falls at 97 are the other Montana cities on that list. Boise, Raleigh, North Carolina, and Madison, Wisconsin make up the top three. A livability survey shows affordability is what matters most to millennials when deciding where to live, so the list focuses on cities with median home values no higher than $250,000 and up to 1 million in population. Well, up next on tonight's 5:30 News, we're out at the St. Jude Dream Home for our first look inside and seeing some of the people who've helped make this life-saving effort happen. And in sports, Scott delivers highlights from 7 state basketball tournaments and shows us which teams reach tomorrow's semis.
And coming up in weather, the temperatures are starting to go up, and so is our chances of snowfall for this weekend. We'll talk more about that coming up in a few more minutes.
You're watching MTN News with Janelle Slade and Russ Riesinger, Storm Tracker Weather with Bob McGuire, and Sports with Scott Breen. This is the 5:30 News on Q2, Montana's news leader.